I want to announce about colovirus. I used to call it colovirus. I want to announce about colovirus. Everybody should forget what that nonsense man said. Everybody should go about doing his business. Before he finished, they were bonding him, beat him, and beat him and throw him out. Because he's not the governor. In governance, I'm talking. So, who is your Lord? Who is your Lord? You should learn to declare the Lordship of Jesus often in your life. Often lay hand on your head and say, thank you, Jesus, because you are my Lord. You know why we don't say this thing? We don't understand the meaning and efficacy, the power that emanates from these things where we say them. But you know the funniest thing? Satan understands. The Bible says he believes, and he does what? He trembles. Devil understand. He studied. He knew all the benefits that is in that name. He understand. So when he's pressing somebody, we don't allow the person to call Jesus. But if you maybe by message shout Jesus, you will notice the oppression will do what? Cease. Is that okay? So what was I trying to tell you? He said these signs will follow them that believe. In my name, they will do what? Cast out devil. In my name, they will speak with what? New tongues. In my name, they will do what? They will tread on snake. They will tread on stomach. He said, in my name, even if they drink, even if they eat, even if they touch coronavirus, it shall not harm them. Why? Because you are born of the incorruptible seed. There are things that does not have power anymore to harm you. We saw it. I've given testimony here one time. I was in the kitchen cooking. I never knew that the gas was leaking, and gas, the whole place was smelling gas. And my husband that just drove in perceived it and ran, was screaming, gas, gas. He came in. He said, Jesus, my wife, what are you doing here? I said, I'm cooking. He said, are you not perceiving the gas? I said, no. He said, Jesus, as he was talking, he rushed outside to go and, well, I was not perceiving anything. It was when my husband off it. And it's like the Holy Spirit released my nose. I can't explain what happened. I discovered all my skin is smelling gas. And I was cooking. Can somebody analyze what happened there? Can you tell me the kind of radiation that took place there? Power collided with power. This one is touch not. And I was busy praying in tongues, doing my cooking. I never knew the whole place. I lied not, I was not aware. So nothing shall by any means do what? Harm us. When we eat it, when we drink it, when we touch it, the virus will die. There are people it does not survive in their system. Who are those generals? Those that are born of God. These are believers. Is that okay? So Jesus Christ was persuading them when he was in his earth work. He said, please believe. All he was preaching is believe. Please, I want you to believe. Why he was begging them to believe? Because you know where he lived. It's only when they believe in what he has said, that is when this thing will begin to manifest. Is that okay? So it's an insult to be telling you believers, believe. It's what? It's an insult to be begging a believer. You enter the kingdom by belief. Why should I be begging you to believe in the word of God? How did you enter? How did you not enter the kingdom? Because the Bible says you must believe in your heart and confess in your mouth. It was that belief, they check in your heart, you believe that you've been reconciled to God, by which is righteousness. They check in your mouth, you confess the Lordship of Jesus. That is why you were brought into the kingdom. How come now you are in the kingdom, you don't want to believe? Who has done this wickedness? And I get it. Galatians 3, verse 1. He said, who has bewitched you? He said, what did he call them? Foolish. What did he call them? Foolish. Oh, foolish Galatians, who has what? Bewitched you, that you should not obey the truth. Before whose eyes Jesus Christ has been evidently sent for crucified among you. Give me verse 2. This only would I learn of you. Receive you the Spirit by the works of the law or by the hearing of faith. Give me verse 3, which is the lie. Are you so foolish? Having begun in the spirit, are you not made perfect in the flesh? How can a believer, they be begging you to believe the word of God? What kind of you come here? How did you enter the kingdom? How did you enter? Did you enter through iPhone? Huh? Did you enter through iPhone or do you enter through text messages? You enter because you believed. Say, I believe I'm the light of the world. So Jesus said unto them, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to them that believe. So seven belief system. I want to use that belief to provoke your spirit. Is that okay? But mind you, I'm not begging you to do what? To believe. The ones I'm begging here to believe is the ones that are not born again. If you're born again, it's an insult to be preaching to you to believe. Because you are a born believer. You are born by the word of God. Hallelujah. Number one of that system, believe that God is and is able. Hebrews 11 says, believe that God is and is able. But without faith, it is impossible to please God. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is. Must believe that he is. He that cometh to God must believe that he is. He is able. He can heal me of this sickness. He can make me pass this jump resort. He can make a way for me where there is no way. He can make my bones to be whole again. He can make my blind to see again. He can resurrect dead. You must believe that he's able. And he is rewarder of such people that believe in, that come to him and believe in him, that seeketh him what? Diligently. He will reward them. But you must believe he's able. You cannot come to somebody where you don't believe. You marry a man. And when you are marrying this man, you saw the man borrowing money everywhere to marry you. And you didn't tell the man stop. And after he has borrowed money, borrowed car to carry to drive you to the church, borrowed suit, borrowed everything. You were seeing him, he was borrowing. And after wedding, you want to be happy. And you want to, because you want to show off. You like the guy, but you don't like the poverty area of him. And after marriage, you want the guy to be, I don't know how I speak it. You want the guy to remain on that level. It's not possible. The guy has to remove all the suit he borrowed. He has to return the car he borrowed. Now you are living a normal life. You are attacking, frustrating the man. Any man that goes to marry, borrow to marry, my dear, you are entering bondage. It's not love. It's not love. I understand the car you are using to come to church. Somebody can honor you with a car. I understand. But going to borrow money, borrow this. Stop borrowing. What you don't have, you don't need it. Stop borrowing. Go and marry a woman that is your slippers, that is your class. His class is a strata problem. If I know, say, the man, if they sell crayfish, he goes to a bar to carry, he goes to Bonnie to carry crayfish and return and sell. And I love him that way. I can't expect much from him. But rather, I will look for a way to, honey, please don't spend much so that anything we get, I will be selling tomato. While you are selling crayfish, we use it to grow. That is marriage. Not trying to impress and oppress. Because anytime you want to impress somebody, you end up oppressing yourselves. Did you hear what I just said? So you must learn to marry somebody according to your level. And start marriage with truth. Start like my husband. He told me I've never opened an account before. I said, that means there is no money in the bank. He said, I don't even get account book. He told me. I said, then how are we going to marry? He said, as God supplies. And I went back to God. Is this the thing you want? God said, that is the thing. He didn't allow me to say, that is the thing. Follow him. He said he doesn't have. He said, follow him. He said, follow him. Isaiah 51 verse, is it verse 3? Isaiah 51 verse 3. Isaiah 51 verse 3. Isaiah 51 verse 3. Okay, give me verse 1. Where is Abraham your father? Okay, give me verse 2. Look unto Abraham your father and unto Sarah that bare thee. For I called him how many? And blessed him how many? And do increase him how many? Increase him. Give me verse 3. For the Lord shall do what? Comfort Zion. He will comfort all her ways, places. He will make her wilderness like what? And her desert like the garden of the Lord. Joy and gladness shall be found therein. Thanksgiving and the voice of men. Who will comfort you? Who will make wilderness turn to Eden? Who will make desert like a garden? So what should I do? Follow. He said, follow him. I said, God, only house that somebody paid for. No, I can't. He said, follow him. If you miss it, you are out of the line forever. Any person you marry, use your hand and fix it. So I have no choice than to be loving, coming closer by force. Did it turn out for good for me today? Yes. Has he made my desert like a garden? Yes. Has he made my wilderness like Eden? Yes. Are you getting what I'm teaching you? So believe. I don't know what he's telling you. Believe. Do all you can to believe that he can do it. If you are not too sure, look from the people where he has done it before. Look from it. If he have done it for Jacob, I think he can do it for me. And God is good in photostatic miracles. That's what I noticed. He's good at photocopying it. Am I speaking to your spirit? So believe that he's able. Believe he is. And believe he is what? Able. Number two, belief system. Believe in the testimonies of others. Luke 1:38. After the angel spoke to him, he said, be it unto me according to thy word. What happened immediately in verse 39? Immediately, the lady said, angel of God, according to your word, I believe you. What happened in verse 9? Oh, girl, take out. She stepped out to go and look for Elizabeth. You know, the angel told him, said, look at Elizabeth. He said, I need testimony to believe that nobody slept with me, a virgin. I need the testimony of somebody. And immediately, what did he do? And Mary arose. I don't know what Bible didn't say immediately. In those days. And went into the hill country. With what? Into the city of Judah. Who should they look for? Elizabeth. And the Bible says, God did not wait for Elizabeth to tell her I'm pregnant. Immediately she entered, the Pekin said, how are you? He said, the Pekin don't even enter, even they greet me. He said, my baby leap. Immediately you spoke. He said, then it's possible. This old woman that is past age, that is not seeing, that is mono. Oh no. If it's possible with her, then my own is a common case. Are you getting what I'm teaching you? Use the testimonies of others. Believe in the testimony of others. If you never disappointed Oko, you will never disappoint me. If you didn't disappoint Godwin, you will not disappoint me. Learn their testimony. Learn what gave them confidence that make them to get how they use patience to get inherit or use patience to inherit their promise. Also use this one thing I like about God. If somebody testifies, say I did like this, I got breakthrough. And you know one thing about God, you also do like this, you will get even more testimony. It's what I've noticed about God. Anyhow the other person got it, follow the person's own. Do the same thing, you will get it. Even surprisingly, your own will be more glorious than the person you emulated. Am I talking to you? Believe in somebody's testimony. Immediately they told her, she said, no, I need somebody to encourage me. The Bible said it. Even in Hebrews 11:11. Before Hebrews 11, what did Elizabeth told her finally? In Luke 1:48. He said, 45. He said, there will be a performance of those things they were told of you if you believe. He said, blessed is she that believeth. Because you believe what God told you and you have seen my own testimony, then your own will perform. You will experience the evidence. There shall be a performance of those things which were told you of God because you believe. Am I talking to somebody's spirit? Am I provoking you to believe what God has said? So many of you, that things God said you've thrown away. There was one that I sat down crying. I said, I don't believe again. No, I don't tire you. I don't tire you. As I was crying in my room, crying. Immediately after a while, I heard a song. This Mary, Mary song. It didn't tell me it would be easy. I don't understand. I've gone this far that I cannot turn back. You didn't tell me it would be easy. It's a Mary, Mary song. Told me that we're so easy. I've gone this far to leave me. The song uses itself, they sing itself, and they look for who the singer. I turned around. He said, it's we that's singing. I said, but I'm not singing. He said, it's the angels that have been assigned to work with you. He said, he can't bring you this far to leave you. Are you angry over what he said? I said, this thing is, how old I am? That is what I'm asking God. How old I am before this thing will manifest? He said, a year. 1,000 years in the sight of man. It's like a year before the Lord. Is there anything hard for me to do? If I can compress, rearrange, and compact 6 children in the womb. During those days, was it anything like that possible? Now, 8 children can be in one. The question I used to ask myself, Pastor Loma, how do they arrange themselves? Do you now understand why the Bible says in Ecclesiastes, he said, you don't know how the bones grow in the womb. Neither will you understand the way of the Lord. How did you package it? Because I know if you are traveling from Port Harcourt to Lagos, I know how Aboro, if you like all of you carry all the load, the Aboro will pack the whole load. It will enter out. Especially if you are going to Onitsha. I don't know that those people are anointed for that business. The way they will arrange, the way they will pack the whole load. Even you yourself, you say, are you serious? All this load enter? Upon that, they will tell you, hey, we don't finish, madam. Your load. For you. But the Lord has sent. I remember that paper that you come down. Your load alone is 3,000. I said, but myself is 1,000. I said, your load is 3,000. If you know greed, no problem. We know the quarry. Make I bring Ganta. He said, okay, make I pay you 1,500. I say, okay, give 3,000 because you talk like human beings. They go. But how did that load enter? Is it not the same vehicle that is carrying the load? Yes. If God can arrange babies in the womb, and the babies will still be turning, 7 children in the womb. Have you seen that and think? Have you ever seen that and think? And I was listening to one of the mothers. He said, the children, this one will be kicking. I said, it's a lie now. Even me with the hair is a lie. How will they be kicking? How will they be kicking? Because there's no space. Still, 7 of them are kicking. When the woman has been up to 7 or 8, she couldn't take. They said, I beg, because of the kicking, wait, let's open you up and just bring them out. Awesome God. If he has done it for somebody, he will do it for me. Say it. Say if he has done it for somebody, he will do it for me. He will not change because of my story. If I've had it, I used to tell God, you have put yourself in trouble by doing it for somebody. That's what I used to tell him. For you to do it for Jacob, you don't put yourself for case. You must do it for me. That's what I used to, oh God. I said, because I didn't know it's possible, but now I've had it. You must for to start it in my own life. And trust God. Your own will be greater, more glorious in Jesus' name. I decree, whatever that looks impossible in your life, by the spirit of the word of God that is compelling you to understand and believe the word, let those impossible turn to possibility in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. So it's possible. In Revelation 19:10, I like the way he put it. He said, the testimony of Jesus is the spirit of what? Prophecy. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I came to testify. I've been married for 5 years. They told me it's 5 broad. I couldn't conceive. I've been going from hospital. And Pastor Beverly, now professor, say in the day he's teaching the 7-6 system of belief. And he said, let the spirit of God that dissolve every impossibility make my womb receive strength like Sarah and conceive. Praise the Lord. I'm here to testify. I just put to bed triplets. You know those things she's doing, shaking on her body, testifying. Is what? Prophecy. Why is prophecy? Her testimony is prophesying to somebody. Her testimony is prophesying. What is prophesying? I'm telling you it will be well with you. I'm telling you will break through. I'm telling you things will overturn. Anytime you are testifying, the spirit of that word is speaking to somebody. I can do greater for you than I've done for her if you believe. So it's the spirit of what? Prophecy. Testimony. That is what one of the things the church lost early those days. Nobody cared for testimony. We'll come to church, pray, everybody will go. Until God start reacting. Miracles belong to you people. Worship and praise belong to me. Above all, I need testimony. It's my work so that men can know and see that I can do these things. Where you hear the blind see, when you are blind, where will you go? That very place. Where you hear the barren conceive, if you are barren, where will you do? Where you hear that jobless people are getting job, if you hear, where will you go? You will go there. Because the God that can do those things, that God is there. Hallelujah. So the testimony of Jesus, the testimony that we give in church, the assured word of what? Prophecy. Number 3, believe. Are you following at all? Believe in his sent word, sent vessels. Believe in his sent vessels. John 1 says, he said there was a man sent from God whose name is what? John. Believe in his sent vessels. There was a man sent by God. His name is what? John. There is a woman sent by God. Her name is what? Pastor Beverly. Believe in the sent vessel. That is one of the things unbeliever has been fighting for 2 years now to use it to weaken the church. But some of you don't understand what devil is doing. It's the devil that is passing through them. They will tell you, oh, your pastor. Oh, your pastor. Oh, your pastor. Oh, your pastor. Your pastor, did they show you all the mistakes of pastors? What they are telling you is that so that you don't believe in their word. Because 2 Chronicles 20:20. What did he say? 2 Chronicles 20:20. He said, believe in your prayer and you will do what? You will prosper. He said, believe in the Lord, you will be expelled. But believe in your pastor, what he's saying, you will prosper. So these people so much believe in their pastor, and that's why they are prosper. So make them, begin all the ones that make mistakes, put it in frontline news. Today, saying that if they show on television that they gave a particular state 10 million and the 10 million they wasted it, nobody will talk. But what, nobody will even care to read it. I bet we don't get used to their line, Nigeria politician. It means a pastor. Everybody go open. Devil know what he's doing. It's some of us that don't know what we are doing. Why? He wants to rubbish them in your heart so that your faith, your trust on them will die. So that he will withdraw you and release what? Arrow and attack. Because you can never be saved without a pastor. Tell your neighbor, you can never be saved without a pastor. You are not wiser than God. He said in Jeremiah 3:15, he said, I will choose pastor for you after my own heart. And they will feed you with knowledge. I am the one that will choose pastors for you. Is any person seeing God here now? Is any person seeing God now? Who is telling you what God is saying? Me. Is your pastor. Then how come you doubt me? They didn't stop there. They said, no, we have succeeded in making them to doubt their pastors. Let's enter another one. Don't pay tithes. You are spending your money. You are giving your money to the church. You are giving your money. All your money. The Bible. Don't give your money. You are giving your money. What are they trying to introduce in your life? Poverty. Are they wiser than God? The Bible says, give, it shall be what? Given to you. Good measure. Pressed down, shaking together, and running. You know one thing about giving? It works for believer and unbeliever. Watch the richest person in your family is the one that give more. Watch. Look now. Watch the richest person in your street is the one that will come and carry rice and be sharing to everybody. Watch. Watch the one that is always going to collect the way they are. The Bible said it in Proverbs 20:11. It said, there is he that scattereth, yet increaseth. But there is he that withholdeth and come to poverty. So they know what they are doing. It's you that doesn't know what you are doing. He said, don't give. How can you carry your money? So because of it, as you're coming to church, you will look for 15 naira and drop. When you have good denomination to give to God, but you prefer to use 1,000 naira to buy food and everything. And the Bible says, the more you give, the more you multiply. He said, it's more blessed to give than to do what? To receive. You say, I'm not going to do it. I'm a pastor, go eat them. If my pastor eat them, all your own way government eat. My husband showed me something on this thing yesterday. 2 COVID-19 bag of rice. They brought for two. The rice, I'm sure inside the rice, maybe it's 5 cups. Okay, let me say camera. Maybe say 6 cups or 10 cups. That the whole Amachi will share. And the people were cursing. The people were screaming. They said, Alakeja gave 2 billion. Dunamis, 2 billion. Uchokafo, 20 billion. Emeka Ofo, 20 billion. Who again? Peter Obi. Okay, I've not seen Peter Obi. Oh, Peter Obi, 1. BBBBB. Where is this money? Instead of giving it to federal government, which is looking at me as I'm talking, I wrote them. I said, why are you people giving money to the wicked? Why are you doing this? And the annoying thing is, you are our fathers. Is it that you are not hearing the cry of the masses? If God has so blessed you, you feel you want to give, why not come to Amachi? Say everybody, or blow an ass in the night. If you know you are an Amachi, please come with your ID card. Come with so person is visiting. Come with bags of rice. Align it. Every landlord, identify your tenant. You carry. God will reward you. Look at it. COVID-19 is competition now. Every state wants to have COVID-19. So that they will give them 2 billion. So even when there's no COVID-19, now message will see the preacher. These are the games that they have so polluted your mind. Tell you don't give. They will show you a pastor that stood in the church raising seed. Why won't we raise it? Why won't we raise it? If the pastor is stealing, God know how to reward him or her. There's a place of sacrifice. There are some sacrifice we made, door open, draw for us. There are sacrifice we made, job. Some sacrifice, we are born for sacrifice. It's our system, it's not their system. If the pastor choose to be a thief, let God punish him or her. It's none of my business. But my Bible told me, when you try and try, it's not working. Give sacrifice, your doors will be open. And I'm believing my God to give. If God didn't say it, the pastor say it. Must God say everything? Did Elijah not say it? According to my word, let there not be rain. As long as he's a man of God, let there not be rain. For the period of 3 years, the heaven obey him and close up. He came back again and said, let there be rain. And the heaven obey him. And the Bible told me of all those that are born of women, there are none greater in the Old Testament than John the Baptist. He said, even the least, we that are the least in the kingdom of God, he said, we are greater. What are we talking about? What are we talking about? They have used, everybody is talking. talking rubbish. They have so rubbish, even some of the ones you respect as man of God. You can see that it's media that is controlling them. So if they didn't insult you as a pastor, you cannot be compassionate. So if they didn't come, if they didn't say, hey, you make money, you are not helping, people are paying tax, so your member will be homeless, you will not provide house for them where you have it. It's wickedness. A media cannot tell me what to do. My Bible tells me what to do. Go home and read Psalm 58. He will teach you. Read Psalm 58, one to the last. He will show you. After you have listened to the poor, after you've given to the needy, he said, the Lord will guide you continually. Verse 11, he will satisfy your soul in drought. He will make fat your bone. You will be like a water garden and like a spring of water. Who fails not? Must the media remind me what to do? If I have it, I will do it. At times you have it, you want to give it to a particular person, God will tell you, don't give. Hey, about that? You want to turn Christianity to what I will get? That's the Christianity we want. Some people want to practice. Oh, if I, at this young man is now, since I'm preaching, he has been reading phone. If I don't give him food, he will not come to church again. So after service, you position yourself to block pastor to collect courses from him. You say you are collecting money. Pastor, give me money. Pastor, give me money for transport. Pastor, give me this one. Check all the people that is collecting from pastor. Just check your life very well. All the free food they are giving them, check their life and the free food. But that does not take the place you should not be merciful. And nobody should remind you to be merciful. Because it's our nature, we are born of love. So they try to corrupt your mind every day. People to give to the work of, give, pastor, go they drive motor. A young man came here and gave my husband formatic. My husband gave my father, what's that motor? My father is a Pathfinder. Jeep. When we have need, God bless us with Pathfinder. God, we want to sell it to solve the need. God said, no, carry it and give to your father-in-law. I will provide it. Immediately we carry the motor. My husband said, no, I won't give him this car. If God has spoken, let me work on the car. My husband now went to work on the car and give to my father. The same day, somebody called and said, God called. I don't know why this has ever happened. God said, I should transfer so amount of money in your account. And that's the exact money we need to solve that issue. We came out from it. Then my husband, in his birthday, young man came here and gave him Formatic. That's what they call this car I'm driving, Formatic. Amen. Gave him Formatic. The same man, the same evening, he did not call, his boss called him. Come, I just want to see you. He said, come, wherever you just come down. Your guy is not aware of it. His friends are not here. It was not announced. Or God just called him. I want to see you. He came. He said, I don't know. If there's any guy here you like here, just pick. Pick up the two. He said, oh God, but I, he said, no, I just feel like it. Anyone you want, just pick two. He said, okay, two. He said, yes. He said, but okay, I told you, I say anyone you like, just pick two. These things don't happen by chance. It cannot happen to you when you're a stingy person. These are the all laws and orders in the spirit. You don't like giving and you want to receive. You cannot receive. Stop lying. Even when a prophecy go ahead of you and you are blessed, you didn't return to continue giving. You cannot prosper. There is a prosperity. There is kingdom prosperity. There is a hard work prosperity. I'm talking of kingdom prosperity. Understand how these things are done. You must be a generous person. They poison your heart every day. Everything God said do, they would poison your heart not to do it. And you read, you move to your friend, pastor. So even if he's a fake pastor, it's not the news. I'm not the judge. I'm not what? Give me Matthew 7. For some of us that like judging people, give me Matthew 7 verse 1. We like judging people. We like judging people. We like judging. Matthew 7. Aboki, give me New Living. Do not judge others, And you will not be what? Give me verse 2. Verse 2. My lovely son. For you will be treated as you treat others. The standard you use in judging is the standard by which you will be what? Judged. Give me 3. And why worry about a speck in your friend's eye where you have what? A log in your eye. One person, I saw somebody wrote something insulting a pastor. I thought, I said, you also follow the talk. He said, why won't I talk? And he called himself a man of God. I said, hey God, Jesus, I bet way small, never come. I said, an adulterer. You left your wife to marry another woman. And you are living with her, having children. You still have man to judge. He said, Pastor Beverly, it's not really so. It's not how you think. I said, keep judging. Already, you're already sitting on a judgment seat. Look at you, an adulterer. You are an adulterer. You have even gone to marry another woman while your wife is still alive. And you have man to judge another. To judge the Lord's anointing. Leave him. God know how to. Are you the one that told God how he killed Saul? Are you the God that told God how he killed Jeroboam? Are you the God that taught God how he killed Omri? God know how to finish people. You must not teach it. David said, not me. Your blood not go there for my head. David run until his cup full. God waste him. Stop judging. If all of you here hearing me, and so many that will hear me on the Facebook, you stop. Abel, leave me alone. Leave my pastor alone. If you don't have anything to talk, face the other side. I love the way some of them are replying now. I saw the rubbish they wrote about Oyedepo. That one has turned to be a toothpick in their mouth. But remember the day your father was dying. The same man spoke, your father came back to life. Remember when you are wounded, confused, the same man spoke, your destiny was corrected. How can I open my mouth to that and insult Kumuyi? How? Even if Kumuyi shit, I go pack him. I never worship with him face to face, but his books. Grace of Jesus saved me, and today I want to speak against Adeboye. What a generation that have mouth to talk. It's because we don't fear God. Just talk. Yeah, go talk my own. Especially this unbeliever, this uncircumcised unbelievers. After talking, the devil bend your neck, you carry your neck. Pastor, pray for me. Pastor, pray for me. Pastor, God, forgive me my sin. Forgive me my sin. Believe in them. No man taketh this one upon himself except he is called of God. Leave them if they fall. The God that called them will bring them up. Me, I know better past them. Then they know better. No, judge anybody. Stay on your lane. Some of the temptation that face him, if you face lead to, you will stop and thought into say. Now we were there ministry, know what they see. The pastor was telling me a story. A girl, he came to do counseling. The girl said that he was laying hand, the girl was romancing his hand. He was removing the girl, hugging, refused, the girl tear her brass, tear her brass, let's cry. Pastor is raping me. They sack him. Pastor talked. Everyone said, we don't want to hear. Sack him. That's why at times some laws we put, let us also hear the Spirit of God. And then I brought her in. Say, thank God you cry out. No wonder his ministry is growing. Women everywhere. Nowadays, if your ministry is filled with women, then you are doing okay. What a generation. You are doing okay. What else do you want me to say? I'm not going to leave me. And then I welcome sister. As God will have it, then I brought another pastor. a firebrand one that have wisdom. That's the, he knows when to, the Bible says, be as wise as serpent. He knows when to be wise as serpent. He knows when to be as gentle as dove. He knows when to be a lion. When he now saw sister, he now said, brother, that's what some pastors now set cameras in their in office. He said, camera. Some of, most of these, most majority of the camera. Remember those days, the biro my husband keep, the biro is a camera. Everything in the office is picking it. The biro he's using. Most of them keep camera now. How dear mama? Now the girl come again. Say, pastor, I have need. I have this. I have this. Pastor say, child. Hey, but the church, the money is not my church money. It's church money. He said, please, I have need. I want every time you're going to meet pastor. Pastor, I need help. $50. Just help me with $200. That's why I told my pastors, anyone you don't understand step, call me. Call me. I will help to bundle you out. Nowadays, it's not pastor that is chasing them. It's them that is chasing pastor. Can you wear cloth? Tighten all your cuffs. Tighten all your bra. Push the bra up. Breast up. You upper chamber, you come and you come to do counseling. As pastor is counseling, all he's seeing is upper chamber. Pastor is called man of. He was a man before God enters him. Hosea 12:13, and by a prophet. Hosea 12:13, by a prophet he brought them. He brought out Israel. You see, it's your pastor that God will use to bring you out. And by a prophet, he also do what? Preserve them. All this cry, coronavirus, who is God using to preserve us? Our pastors. He's them. Come out of him, of her. You come out. Praise the Lord. When my father in the Lord prayed for me, this thing was tormenting. My mother in the Lord prayed for me, the thing left me. Did you see God physically cast it out? He passed through me. How are you speaking against such men? If them, those days, I don't know what they taught them is not what they taught us. What they taught us is, if they are naked, cover their shame and be praying for them. That is what we did. Ujon, Sister Uloma, there's something I don't understand about our pastor. Look at the dreams I have. Please, let's do 1 week fasting for our pastor. I did it. That's what we do. We pray, oh God, destroy this. Let this dream not come to pass. Pastor, we will never testify. Pastor doesn't know we pray for him. Because anything you pray for another, it can never happen to you. That's one thing you don't know. Anytime somebody gave testimony, oh, and God delivered me from the accident, you get up and carry money. You know what I say? All the days of your life, you can never experience that and talk of to see it. Because for you to appreciate God for deliverance of another, you have also paid for such thing not ever to happen to you or your children. Somebody was asking me, say, why is it that when they give testimony, you go and drop offering? As I'm telling God, I appreciate you for giving victory, but I know this thing, I will never see it. There are things no see I'm talking of to testify. Fire born, remain only here. Praise the Lord. No see I'm talk of to do with him. To testify. So I hear. So respect your pastors. Romans 1:11. He says he's coming. Romans 1:11. That Paul speaking. He says he's coming to impart unto them a spiritual gift. For I long to see you that I may impart unto you some what? Spiritual gift. What is this spiritual gift? Word of knowledge, word of wisdom, spirit of faith, working of miracles, gifts of healing, the diversity of tongues. I want to, so that you be strong in the spirit. Who among you receive Holy Ghost here without pastor? Not me, but my own pastor was from radio, from cassette, Renan Bonke. I was in my room, he was preaching. Crusade, he went in. I don't know whether it's Kano or Jaws. He said, are you ready? I said, yes, in my room. I was saying it. One heart was serious, one heart was not serious. He said, receive the Holy Ghost. And so when a bonky spirit kukuma enter me. That's how I receive Holy Ghost baptism. But anywhere you receive it, there is a voice you heard. That was God speaking through the voice of a man. Respect them. Revere them. Love them. Care for them. Pay your tithe. Honor them with your substance so it will be well with you. Honor them. Is that okay? We know the story in Exodus 3:8-11. God said, I've seen the cry of the children of Israelites. Continue. My interest is in verse 11. After God said they are being oppressed, they are being harassed. Give me verse 11, 3:11. After everything, look at what said. Give me 10. After God have said everything, I was thinking God will come down to go and deliver them. Come now, therefore, I will do what? Send thee unto Pharaoh. That thou mayest do what? Bring forth my people, the children of Israel, out of what? Egypt. But God is the one that saw the oppression. God is the one that saw the problem. But he said, come, I want to send you. Adam, follow me. Go and free them. Why didn't God come down physically? He possessed the rod of Aaron to give deliverance. He possessed the voice of voice of Moses and the voice of Aaron to give deliverance. But he passed through man. Even God respect man. Even angel respect man. Even when they are dragging the body of Moses, the angel did not accuse him. He carried his body and went to heaven. But we, this cloth where she wear now my money. If I know where, if you know buy cloth, who go buy for me? I know they work for Shell again. Where I go get the money from? Make I go steal? Now what you not tell honor me for birthday? God said this time, don't give, use it to buy clothes. I went to buy clothes. See people go top for this okra cow. But when your picking one swallow bone, bone who can ascend pastor? The same pastor you are calling. Ask yourself whether you have ever dropped tithe to take care of the church. Ask yourself, have you ever remember one cutter of indomie to see her or him? Pastor, I want to see you. Pastor, I want to see you. Pastor, I want to see you. Pastor, touch me. Pastor, make me. Pastor, honor me. Pastor, pastor, pastor. 2 Chronicles 4:7. 2 Corinthians. The excellency of the power is of him. 2 Chronicles said, but we have this treasure. Everybody look at that scripture. But we have this treasure, this gift, this anointing. Where is the anointing? In an earthen vessel, in a physical body. That the excellency of the power may be of who? God and not of us. That is man of God. Number 4. Believe his words spoken. Believe his words spoken. John 8:30. Believe his words spoken. When they speak the word of God, believe her. As he sparked these words, many did what? Believed on him. Don't despise the word of God. Don't do what? Don't despise the word of God. Don't despise it. 1 Thessalonians 5:22. Don't despise 1 Thessalonians 5:22. Don't despise the word of God. Don't despise it. 1 Thessalonians 5:22. 1 Thessalonians. Huh? No, now 5:20. I'm sorry. Even me, I have that scripture often. 1 Thessalonians 5:20. No, not 2:13. Okay, hence leave 2. Okay. Despise not what? Prophecies. Did he end with CY? He end with what? What have I been doing all this time I'm talking? I'm prophesying. Not prophecy. CY. Revelation. I'm talking of SY. Don't despise it. Don't make. If you do, give me Proverbs 13:13. Say, don't despise it. Don't. What is this one they talk? What is this one they preach? Now, this thing I waste my time coming here. Whosoever despises the word of God shall be what? Shall be this. Don't despise it. Don't rubbish the word of God. I used to tell people, one day God told me make a study, and the pastors and their children. he started showing me all the children of pastor, why they died. People that are close to pastors, why they died. You don't know that when you are living with a pastor, you are more dangerous than members that come from outside. Because you are experiencing the human in them and the God in them. So at times, when you react the human part of you, they say, but you be pastor, why you they react like this? If you know one, make a react. If you know that thing, it tells you to do what? Do it. Do it. Of all the anointing that worked with Moses, where are the children of Moses? Who is the first prophet in Israel? Samuel. Show me one of his child name written in the Bible. You can see him now. Eli. Hophinehas and Phinehas. Carry go. What happened? Isaac. Pastor. What happened to his son? Esau. He went to marry Judith. Unbeliever. Because of it, the mother hated her to death. He hated him to death. The same people they said they should not marry. He went to marry an unbeliever, Judith. Make her the mention. Children, no be Judith, no be by name, not the name of the lady. Make her the mention, then too plenty. What of Saul? He died with the whole household. That even when he died, the children he come by his hide. A particular Gibbon said that God said the plague will not end until they waste all the concubines, all the children, even his girlfriend. They trace all the sons and waste them. The only seed of Saul on earth is by the mercy and covenant David had with Jonathan. All seed of Saul. Make a dimension. Which one will drink? Noah, Ham, Shel, and Jephthah. Is there anything mentioned about them? These are children of pastors. These are children of pastors. Your father will stand in the church and say, out, demons will tremble, but he will tell you in the house, do something. He will stand like this. So the anger and wrath of God keep on heaping on the child. Let's be careful of ministers. I don't know why I went there. Let's be careful. So our ways will not be closed. But rather you go to them, please. If this thing I'm doing is angry, what will I do to make you happy? But say, he that beareth the sword, beareth not in vain. Hebrew 13:7. He said, does not bear it in vain. If your father is a pastor, he can talk. Do you know what it takes for demons to be cast out? Do you know what it takes for powers to go off people and release them? But you are the one that is rebelling against your father at home. Now, quick check. So, don't despise the words of God. The Bible says in 1 Thessalonians 2:13. Give it to me. For this cause also thank we God without ceasing. I love this scripture so much. It saved me. Because when you receive the word of God, which you heard of us, you receive it not as the word of what? Man. But as in the truth, the word of God, which what? Effectively worketh unto you that do what? Believe. So believe in the word spoken, all right? You will have freedom. Number 5. Believe and doubt not. Believe and doubt not. Then you will see the possibilities of God. Mark 11:23. Believe and doubt not, then you will see the possibilities of God. For very, very I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou what? Removed and be cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe in those things which he saith, but shall believe that those things which he saith shall come to pass. What will happen? He shall have whatsoever. The main thing there is whatsoever he saith. Anytime you say this one, she did. Believe in his name. Believe in the name of Jesus Christ. The name of Jesus, higher than name, the King of the earth, no other name like him. The name of Jesus, Alpha, and Omega, there's no one else like him. So the name of Jesus, there's no name like him. It's higher than every other name. That name is powerful. You not go know until you engage it. You like talking about it, but you have never engaged it. And when you know whether the name is, engage it where there is no possibility. You see how it will turn impossible to be possible. Hallelujah. Finally, believe in yourself. Believe in yourself. Dream large and see ahead. Believe in yourself. Yes, you have done well. You have believed in God. You have believed in so many servants. You also believe in yourself. Dream large and see ahead. Jeremiah 1:11 and 12. Jeremiah 1:11 and 12. That's where I stop. Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Jeremiah, what seest thou? And I said, I see a rod of almond tree. 12, my son, 12. 1, 2, go, everybody, read it together. Then said the Lord unto me, thou hast seen well, for I will hasten. That thing you have seen, that is why we hasten. What are you seeing? What are you dreaming? Some of us, as I'm talking to you, none of you is dreaming to buy a car of 12 million. Those things that were not as if though they were, they come to be. The Spirit of God go with your dream. Dream I'm talking of here is not breathe me. I run out, I saw snake, I run down, I saw lion. That's not what I'm talking about. That's not what I'm talking about. Talking of your future. Dream. Last Sunday, dream to become the minister of finance in Nigeria. Don't walk empty. Where I am is the dream I dreamt yesterday. Some of you, nothing is working because you are not dreaming. Dream of your daughter, for God settling them in high position. Don't dream for poor people to marry your children. It's not a blessing. For some of you that think poverty shows you are humble in Christianity, don't marry a poor man. Don't marry a poor man. See my mouth, read them. I don't rub lipstick. Don't marry a poor man. Poverty is not addition, it's suppression. Don't marry him. Let him go and define his life. There are battles you must fight as a young man alone. Battles you must do what? Fight alone. I hate people. When you notice as a young woman you have a problem, now you pretend as if you don't have a problem. You are looking for a husband. What kind of rubbish is that? You now wait when you marry, you begin to solve it. You are not seeing mercies now. War for whatever that block your offering to release it for your mercies to come out. Don't wait when you marry. Give man unnecessary burden to carry you up and down. You discover there's a fibro. War now to break it or to use faith to crush it. If you discover it after marriage, one side, you're a fool. As a young girl, you should go and run tests to examine yourself before you marry. Find out your genotype. If it's AA, it's AS. Don't stupidly fall in love to AS and tell me to pray. Rather, as a young girl, a young man, use the blood of Jesus to change the genotype to AA. It's possible. If you don't have faith, take other people's testimonies. Correct things that are wrong in your life now. So when you are married, you become an asset, not a liability. Nonsense. Become an asset. You know the respect. How they go respect you? You are couple-less. You are nothing less. When it comes to marriage, respect don't be by marriage. Yo. Respect, you earn it. That responsibility where you they take care of, no shaking. They make woman, they submit anyhow. they agree every time. It's not that free, oh. Even though the Bible says you should not withhold. You don't want to withhold, but there are things that will make your body to resist. Let's be honest. Don't carry the whole burden and give to a woman. A woman is dying. And you are saying, according to the word of God, you are talking rubbish. Talking rubbish. There are some battles you must fight. Your man now. Settle it now before you marry. If I'm marrying you by faith, I'm not married by faith because you're going somewhere. If a man is dry cleaner, you want to marry as a dry cleaner. Two of us should focus, dream on something. As for getting married, if dry cleaning is your dream, I want to join with you. Anything we get from marriage, let us buy a bigger mansion. Let there be a focus, a target. Just marry a man because he loves me. After marriage, no food, no money. Love go die. Share you the record now. Love go do a thing, he go die. One of the things that kill love in marriage, owoda. When you see why they provoke anyhow. When you stay single, you know they hot temper. Now you marry, you are ten temper. Something is wrong. Define yourself. Define yourself. Dream now. Get something you hold in your hand before you marry. Don't empty marriage, empty. If you're a pastor, there must be a vision you are pursuing. Don't just enter marriage like that. I prepare myself. I know I'm called, I'm choosing. I went to school. Nothing. Well, you told me, if God cannot help us, then let it be so. I will not forget the day my sister came and squeezed with her 50,000 into my hand. I refused. Me and my sister, we are fighting. She's squeezing, I'm refusing. Two, my sister carried the money and threw me. I pursued her, going out of my gate. I threw the money through her window into her car. Because if I bring it in, it will be war. My husband has threatened me, will kill me and kill himself. For some of you, Auntie, we couldn't pay school fees. Help us transfer. Help us. Every day they are helping you. Every day they are helping you. Which day will you stand? Which day will you stand? That person, where you they call? He don't call you before. Am I provoking somebody's spirit? Tell yourself, get up. Tell yourself, get up. Your star will never manifest as long as you are depending on men. I was watching a testimony. I end up with this. A man I went to, man, I don't want to mention the church. The day they gave the testimony, me, I stood up too. He told the girl, "Sir Sorok, take light." The girl said, "But I love you." She didn't say, "God told me." She said, "But I love you. You are everything I desire in a man." He said, "But there's no light in Sir Sorok." The girl said, "I will marry you like that." God. Say, God. Many women say they have sign of marriage. You never spoke to me, but this is the first. You know, there are some people who want to see them. Some, everything in you will align and agree. This is him. He said, I love this man. This is everything I need in a husband to serve you, God. This woman started praying. They wedded. Light, no, never no bring life and sorrow. Unknowing to the night of their wedding, never brought light, they didn't know. Make when I get up, I'm afraid.